Disaster! Something truly horrible and terrible has happened. Something so awful that it is hard to put into words. But I will try. Sybil has gone. Not my sister. If that happened, I wouldn't be upset at all. Mo, my beautiful, eight-legged, Goliath, bird-eating spider. Sybil has gone. Vanished. Perspex tank and all. As soon as I came home from school, I went straight upstairs to tell Sybil about my day. I was going to tell her how Mr. Truss said we weren't allowed footballs in the playground because they're dangerous. About how we walked home over the fields, seeing how many times we could bounce the ball off Claude's head. How I saw a large silver car going down our street, which I'm sure was driven by none other than that crook Lysander Witzel. I was going to give Sybil a mouse I'd sneaked out of the freezer to defrost while I was at school. But Sybil wasn't there. There was only her lamp, which was shining over the scrape marks where the tank had been. I ran straight downstairs, where I found Mum in the kitchen preparing a brown goo. Mum! Mum! Have you seen Sybil? Well, she's not back from school yet, is she? I don't mean her! I mean my beautiful Sybil with eight hairy legs! She shuddered. That Sybil is anything but beautiful. I don't know how I can bear having her in the house. I searched the whole house. By the time I'd finished, Mum had put the brown goo in the oven to froth and was in the living room reading the Ocklesford Gazette. I came in, frantic. For goodness sake, Dougie, what is the matter with you? I told you, Sybil has gone. Sybil is in her room doing her homework, like you should be doing instead of charging round the house. I mean the nice Sybil with eight hairy legs, not the horrible Sybil with two hairy legs. Mum went pale. When you asked me whether I'd seen your giant tarantula, I assumed you meant, had I ever seen her? That is what you meant, isn't it, Dougie? Mum, I sighed, Sybil, the rare Goliath bird-eating spider, is no longer in my room. Mum made a funny noise, a sort of cross between a cough and a gurgle, with a touch of squeak. And then she screamed, "Aah!" When Dad came home, she was standing on the coffee table, still screeching her head off, "Aah!" while the dog ran around barking. "Christabel," said Dad, "why are you screaming on the coffee table? And why is the Oxford Gazette all over the floor? And why can't you stop the dog from making that infernal racket?" "The thing has escaped, Roy. There's a plate-sized tarantula on the loose in the house. Help!" "Dougie," growled Dad, in that way he does when everything is bound to be my fault. "Her tank has gone," I said. "I've searched the house and I can't find it." "Well, it's probably buried under the heap of rubbish on the floor in that pit of a room of yours," said Dad. "Have you looked?" "Yes, her tank is not in the house." "Are you sure she was in it?" Oh, that was a silly thing to say. Mum jumped from the coffee table onto the kitchen table to do more shrieking. "Ah!" I told her not to worry, because if Sybil had got out of her tank before it went missing, she would stay out of the way in a dark corner and only come out to pounce. Mum screamed even more. "Ah!" I left her to it and started to search all the dark places in the house that Sybil might have hidden in. I was deep into the hall cupboard when Sybil came downstairs. "Oh, get out of my way, and why are you putting rubbish everywhere, you stupid little twerp," she said. "I'm trying to find your namesake," I said. "She's gone at walkies. She could be anywhere waiting to pounce. You should have heard her scream." "Ah!" But it was no good. Sybil's tank had gone, and I knew deep down that she was in it. She could be anywhere.